Hello everyone. In the previous video, we have done discussion of estimation of albumin by BCG method. In today's video, we will do discussion of estimation of total protein by BioRate method, along with discussion of Viva question and demonstration. So please watch this video till the end. Running objective for today's video are, first we will see functions of plasma protein, then we will see principle of BioRate method, operational procedure, interpretation of values of total protein, discussion of Viva question, and in the end we will see demonstration of estimation of total protein by BioRate method. To download lecture notes and other interesting stuff related to biochemistry, please visit website biochemistrybasics.com. So first, introduction. Blood contains large variety of proteins with different functions. Most of these proteins are synthesized in the liver, except hormones and immunoglobulins. Albumin, globulin, and fibrinogen are the major proteins which are present in blood or in plasma. Fibrinogen is utilized in the clotting of blood, so it is absent in serum. So we can say that serum is defibrinated plasma. Hence, by convention, serum protein refers to albumin and globulin, which are present in definite ratio. If a blood is kept without adding anticoagulant, after some time it will clot and remaining portion is called as a serum. Hence, serum is plasma minus fibrinogen. Now we will see function of plasma protein. So the first and important function of plasma protein is maintenance of colloidal osmotic pressure, which is mainly due to the albumin. Second important function is maintenance of acid-base balance, that is due to the buffering action of protein. Third important function is that they help in the transport of various molecules which are not water soluble. The protein which help in the transport of these molecules are albumin, alpha globulin, and beta globulin. Albumin helps in the transport of bilirubin, three fatty acids, various metal ions like calcium, Cu+2, and the transport of various drugs. Then lipoproteins help in the transport of lipid. Transcortin help in the transport of cortisol. Ceruloplasmin help in the transport of Cu+2. So these are the various molecules transported by various plasma proteins. Fourth important function is they play important role in the defense mechanism, that is mainly due to the gamma globulins or immunoglobulins. The last important function of plasma protein is they play important role in the blood coagulation, that is mainly due to the fibrinogen. So this is all about functions of plasma proteins. Now plasma protein is albumin plus globulin plus fibrinogen, and globulin includes alpha 1 globulin, alpha 2 globulin, beta globulin, and gamma globulin. And in the serum, that is defibrinated plasma. The normal concentration of total protein is 6.5 to 8.5 gram per deciliter. Normal concentration of albumin is 3.5 to 5 gram per deciliter. Globulin concentration is 2.5 to 3.5 gram per deciliter. Fibrinogen concentration is 200 to 400 milligram per deciliter. And normal AG ratio is 1.2:1 to 2.5:1. So these are the normal concentration of total protein, albumin, globulin, fibrinogen, and AG ratio. Now, principle of BioRate method for total protein estimation. All compounds containing two peptide bonds react with cupric ions in alkaline medium to form a purple color complex. This is due to the coordination of cupric ions with the unshared electron pairs of peptide nitrogen and the oxygen. The absorbance of the complex is measured colorimetrically at 540 nanometer wavelength. So that is the principle of BioRate method. Now operational procedure. So take three test tubes and label them as blank, standard, and test, and then proceed as follow. In the blank test tube, take 1 ml of normal saline. In the standard test tube, take 1 ml of protein standard. Concentration of protein standard is 5 gram per deciliter, and in the test tube take 1 ml of diluted serum. Then in blank standard and test tube add 5 ml of bioreact reagent. Mix the contain and keep at room temperature for 10 minutes incubation period, and after 10 minutes incubation period read colorimetrically at 540 nanometer wavelength. After taking the optical density at 540 nanometer wavelength, enter the optical density of blank standard and test into this observation table. Then do the calculation of serum total protein in gram per deciliter by entering the value of optical density of blank standard and test into this formula. That is optical density of test minus optical density of blank divided by optical density of standard minus optical density of blank multiplied by concentration of standard. As we have already discussed, concentration of standard is 5 gram per deciliter. So after entering the value into this formula, you can calculate the concentration of total protein in gram per deciliter. Now normal value of total protein. Normal value of serum total protein is 6.5 to 8.5 gram per deciliter. Normal value of albumin is 3.5 to 5 gram per deciliter, and the normal value of AG ratio is 1.2 is to 1 to 2.5 is to 1. So that is about the normal range of total protein, albumin and AG ratio. Now condition which increases the plasma protein, that is hyperproteinemia. So the causes of hyperproteinemia. First cause is dehydration, which can be due to severe vomiting and diarrhea. Dehydration leads to hemoconcentration, which is due to the decrease in the plasma volume. So this condition leads to hyperproteinemia. Second cause for the hyperproteinemia is multiple myeloma. Third cause is inflammatory disorder. Fourth cause is chronic infection like tuberculosis, respiratory distress and hemolysis. So these are the causes of hyperproteinemia. Remember, dehydration leads to hemoconcentration, which causes decrease in the plasma volume. So that's why there is a hyperproteinemia. Now causes of hypoproteinemia, that is decrease in the plasma protein value. So first and important cause is malnutrition and malabsorption. Second important cause is nephrotic syndrome, as there is a loss of protein via kidney. Third important cause is cirrhosis of liver. Fourth important cause is severe burns. Now, which are the other methods for the estimating proteins? So the first important method for the estimating protein is nitrogen estimation by gel dye technique. Second method is Lowry's method for estimating tyrosine estimation, and the third method is turbidimetric method. So these are the other method for the estimation of protein. First one is gel dye, second one is Lowry's, and the third one is turbidimetric method. Now discussion of viva questions. The first question is, what is the normal range of total protein? So it is 6.5 to 8.5 gram per deciliter. What is the principle of bioreact method? So we have already discussed in the earlier slide. Third question is, what are the functions of proteins? Again, we have already discussed that it plays important role in the maintenance of colloidal osmotic pressure. It plays important role in the regulation of acid-base balance. It plays important role in the transport of various molecules. It plays important role in the coagulation. So these are the various functions of proteins. It also acts as enzymes and hormones. Causes of hyper and hypoproteinemia. So we have already discussed the causes of hyper and hypoproteinemia. Fifth question is, what are the methods for the estimation of protein? So the first method is bioreact, then second method is gel dye method, third method is Lowry's method, and the fourth method is turbidimetric method. How different fractions of plasma proteins are separated? So different fractions of plasma proteins are separated by electrophoresis. Then another method is salt precipitation, by which we can do the precipitation of albumin and globulin. So these are the discussion of viva questions. Now we will see demonstration of estimation of total protein by bioreact method. So we have already seen the principle of
estimation of total protein by BioRate's method. Now we will see the operational procedure for the same. So first you have to take 3 test tube, and then you have to mark 3 test tube as a blank, standard and test. Then in the blank you have to take 1 ml of normal saline. Remember, in BioRate's method we are taking normal saline in the blank. Then 1 ml of protein standard in the standard test tube, and the concentration of protein standard is 5 gram per deciliter. Concentration of protein standard is 5 gram per deciliter. And then in the test tube you have to add 1 ml of test. After adding blank, standard and test, then you have to add 5 ml of BioRate's reagent in the blank test tube. With the help of bottle dispenser. And then 5 ml of BioRate's reagent in the test tube. After adding blank, standard and test, you have to keep it in 10 minutes incubation period, and after 10 minute incubation you have to take optical density of blank, standard and test at 540 nanometer wavelength. So this is after 10 minutes incubation period. As you can see, there is a change in the color of standard and test. Now we will take the optical density of blank, standard and test on the colorimeter. Before taking optical density, we will set the zero by giving water blank. So we have already set the zero by giving water blank. Now we will take the optical density of blank, standard and test on 540 nanometer filter. So first you have to transfer the reagent in the flat bottom test tube, then wipe out the flat bottom test tube, and then take the optical density. So that is the optical density of blank. Then optical density of the standard. So that is the optical density of standard. And then optical density of test. So that is the optical density of test. Now you have to feed this value in the formula, and then you have to calculate the concentration of total protein. So that is all about estimation of total protein by BioRate's method. Thank you for watching. Thank you.